Hi, I'm Jenny Jones, a chartered physiotherapist, and on behalf of the ISCP, I'm here to talk about your taper. Tapering is as much an art as it is a science. After all of your hard work and months of training, now comes the psychological work of reining in the running. While a few weeks of tapering does a body good, it can wreak havoc on the mind. Many runners report feelings of restlessness, frustration, irritability, lethargy, disinterest, and physical sensations of niggling pains and stiffness. These effects are normal. Don't have a taper tantrum. As tough as the sensation of tapering is, after all, you've had the drive to log all those miles week in and week out, tapering has been shown to be beneficial for many types of athletes. There is a lot of information on tapering with different recommendations with regards to length, type, and pattern of tapers, and it can be hard to know what is best for you. Tapering includes altering the patterns of your training volumes, intensities, and frequencies. While a taper of anywhere from 4 weeks to 1 week has been shown to be beneficial, a taper of 2 weeks has been shown to have the most positive effect on performance, particularly in runners. During the 2 week taper, decreasing your training volume by 41 to 60% provides ideal performance benefits. No additional effects from decreasing frequency or intensity have been found. So give yourself a good 2 weeks of lesser mileage, but keep your pace up and run as often as you were running before your taper. Unfortunately, there's not too much that can be done for the taper madness, so try to indulge in some self-care to take your mind off of all of your newfound free time, and have a good run.